start. Okay, hey guys, Scarlett's missing. Oh no, she'll be back, don't worry. We got Larry Hankin here. We're continuing on with our very special interview from the Talking Stick in Venice, California. And we have viewers. Thank you guys for being here. And I know we've got, we got a recorded audience. I'm glad, appreciate you guys watching and supporting TedTV. And
continue. I just want to add one thing.
Oh my God.
I mean, don't get the idea that it's all, you know, imagination and art.
But it did sound like a time of growth for you guys, both of you. It sounded like a time of growth for both of you and really interesting art things. And
now, being home like kids is fun because I'm at the point where
I'm kind of the snapping level where I want a place. And I've already started looking for
it. Oh, you have?
But if you have a wound, if you're injured, if you get sick,
oh crap,
if you're not smart, if you're not, you know, into it, if you have a child, I don't recommend it.
I wouldn't recommend that.
This is not fun.
Do you have kids?
It was partly voluntary, and then I got lost in it. And it's like going down a rabbit hole. You meet the Queen of Hearts, you know? You meet rabbits. You meet, you know, also
meet
rats
Mad
and
Hatters.
Snakes. You meet Mad Hatters. So I don't want to just, it ain't all fun and games. I had fun and games.
Right.
And I made fun and games. And it was, you know, I mean, I don't begrudge anybody any experience, including myself.
Right.
But I don't, you know, I just want to give an even, you know, an even read to it, okay?
You mentioned a little while ago that Bob Dylan tried to buy a swapping for a photo of yours.
Well,
I would love to hear that story.
What happened was, I had been writing stuff. It turns out I started out as a stand-up comedian
in
the village when Bob Dylan was there back in the day. Well, you know, I was running around, kids, and I would get up on stage. Now, many, many years later, that was in the 60s. Many years later, almost 1969 is 9 years later, when Bob Dylan was Bob Dylan. And nobody was anybody back in the day. He came to the committee, and he said that he had watched me and was a fan of my stand-up back in the village. I didn't know that. He didn't. He wasn't Bob Dylan then, he was just somebody else in the
room,
playing guitar, you know. And I had seen him, didn't know who he was, but I had seen him. And so he said, you know, this is really cool. What do you want to do? Maybe we'll write something together, you know, that's really cool. And so I wrote this poem, which was kind of an idea for a movie, but I wrote it at a time. And he saw it, and he thought it was really cool, and he wanted to do something with it. And that was one of the things that got thrown overboard when my landlady threw everything overboard. I was living on my houseboat.
And you're kidding.
But many years later,
that hurts physically.
Yeah, it was a really good poem. And he really wanted to publish it. Many years later, I was going through my stuff, and I found, because I had cut and pasted for the first draft. I used to use scissors. Now you can do it on a computer. It's called cutting and pasting. But back in the day, we really actually did cut and paste.
Yeah.
With glue and a scissor. So I had cut and pasted this thing before I typed it out. I'm going through my stuff many, many years later, and I find one line that had fallen off the page. It was a cut and had been pasted line from that thing that was thrown over. But it was, and I have it somewhere. You know, I just put it in a little book. I don't remember what the line is now, but it was a great fucking line. It was a great line, man. So to this day, I go, man, what a poem that was to me.
That's awesome.
But it kind of reminds you of, man, if that was good, what the hell else is down at the
bottom?
But here's a weird thing. 2 years after that episode, living in San Francisco, I go to a party, you know, friends party, you know, where all your friends come. You haven't seen in 2 or 3 years. And in walks this friend of mine, a woman, wearing a shirt that was mine. And I go, where the hell did you get that shirt? She said, I found it washed up in the bay. Are you serious? It was a really good shirt. It was a shirt that I had bought in Africa, you know, when I was traveling. So that's how I recognized it. It was a one-off. It was one of a kind. You know, some tribesman had knitted it.
Or something. Did she give it back
to you? No. She was, I said, that's my shirt. You know that? She said, how do you? I found it in the weeds, washed up on the shore of the bay. And no, you can't have it back. I said, fine. Because she was really taking care of it. She pressed it deeply. She.
Yeah, really cool. Still.
But so one line in a shirt is all like,
wow. Oh, and a great story.
God knows, but that's a great story. Yeah. Yeah.
That seriously,
as a writer,
I'm
going to say
that's so
funny.
It's funny because like I live my life differently now. Like I totally accept everything happens for a reason, and I just go with it. I don't even got to. Yeah, but you know, there are people still that, like when my computer was stolen, you were like, oh, I'm so sorry. I'm like, I'm sorry. You know, what's supposed to happen, you know?
It was
like,
he was very chill about it.
I never, my blood pressure didn't even go up because I just came to this great acceptance place. I just got here.
Did you come to a learning place yet?
But this has been a learning place. This is Davey right over there has taught me so much about, you know, because I think of who I was when I arrived at Venice 5 months ago and how much I just continued to just blossom and mature and grow and become responsible and through this effort because I'm getting roots of human man. Oh yeah, and this bookstore there has been such a blessing. Let me put my hand in your face. I've been reading books on personality behaviors and psychology and self-help.
Big up books here.
It's awesome. And so I've been reading, and then my friendships with my friends here, you know, I've developed some really strong friendships because I think all these 46 years before I broke myself, I wasn't real with people. I was acting. I was faking.
He was very much what he thought people wanted him to be.
I was trying to be what my wife wanted me to be.
So we all...
Yeah. Oh, we do, yeah.
And so I don't know how to behave with people right on one-on-one. And I've had some really fun nights, and I've had some really bad nights here, you know. And that's my learning, you know. And I'm learning from my fellow friends here, and I'm developing friendships that I cherish. Because I've never felt such a strong friendship with people. And so, yeah, I'm in my learning place, and
I've learned to not... See, just from this little talk here, I've learned to not leave my computer.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no.
That's what I've
seriously,
learned.
No,
so
not
this
for,
is a learning experience.
Yes,
and we're going to come back here.
This is.
I finish right up. Back in two.